Good morning, dear children. How are you all? Hope all are doing good at your home. Are you studying well? Yes. Did you do the homeworks? Yes. What about the activities? Yes, I saw. One or two students did your activities and homeworks very well. They did the activities very well. I am very happy. Congratulations. Keep it up. Okay. What about others? Children, it's not good. Everybody should do the activity. Okay? You should do the activities. In third term examination, you will get 5 marks for doing activities. Listen here. In third term exam, you will get 5 marks for doing activities. So what you have to do? Yes, everybody should do the activities and take the video or photo and upload the videos and photos into our WhatsApp group. Okay, don't miss this 5 mark. Did you understand? Yes, so everybody should do the activities. Okay, let us start today's class. Are you ready?
Children, we weigh a thing to know how heavy or light it is, isn't it? Similar to length, weight can also be measured in two ways, by using objects and by using standard weights and weighing machines. Look at this picture. Yes, this is an example for measuring by using object. Clear? By using this balance, we measured the weight of these two objects. We got, yes, this ball is a light ball and this one is a heavy ball. Okay, to know the weight of an object, we compare its weight with another object. Okay, the next second method is by using standard weights and weighing machines. See here, to get exact weight, every time we weigh a thing, we need fixed measure. Grams and kilograms are the most commonly used measures of weight. Grams and kilograms are the most commonly used measurements of weight. Clear? Do you know what is gram? Gram is a small fixed measure of weight. What is gram? Gram is a small fixed measure of weight. See here, it is used to weigh light object like chalk, pencils, gold, etc. Okay, gram is written as G in short. Gram is written as G in short. Did you understand? Yes, gram is a small fixed measure of weight. What is gram? Gram is a small fixed measure of weight. It is used to weigh light objects like chalk, pencil, etc. Clear? Gram is written as G in short. Gram is written in G in short. Clear? The next one is kilogram. See here, kilogram is a bigger measure of weight. What is kilogram? Yes, kilogram is a bigger measure of weight. It is used to weigh heavy objects like pumpkins, bags of rice and sugars, etc. Clear? Kilogram is a bigger measure of weight. Kilogram is written as kg in short. How can we write? Kg in short. Clear? Now, you see here, 1000 gram, we told gram is the small measure of weight. 1000 gram is equal to 1 kilogram. 1000 gram is equal to 1 kilogram. 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram. Everybody should learn this equation. 1000 gram is equal to 1 kilogram. 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram. Did you understand? Yes. Next we are going to learn. See here. Next we are going to do a worksheet. You have to tell how can we measure the weight of this given objects in kilogram or gram. Look at the pictures. First one is a flower. Yes, tell me, what's the measure of a flower, gram or kilogram? Yes, we know a flower is a light object, isn't it? So we can measure in grams. Clear? Weight of a flower in grams. What about an elephant? Yes, What about an elephant? Yes, we know an elephant is a heavy animal, isn't it? So we will measure the weight of an elephant. Yes, in kilogram. Clear? Weight of an elephant in kilogram. What about these chocolates? In gram. A sack of sugar? In kilogram. What about pumpkin? Weight of a pumpkin? Yes, in kilogram. Did you understand? Yes, very good. Next we are going to learn weighing machines. Weighing machines. You must have seen the metal weights and balance which the local vegetable or food sellers use to weigh things. Did you ever see this all? Yes. The pan balance, see here. These are commonly used weights. These are pan balance. These are the commonly used weights, kilograms and grams. These are pan balance. These are digital weighing machines. Clear? Now, let us make a beam balance. This pan balance is also known as a beam balance. Take two coconut shells of same size and two pieces of thread of equal length and try to make a beam balance like this. Okay, everybody should do this activity. Okay, tell your parents to help you. With the help of your parents, everybody should do this activity. Okay, take this two coconut shells of same size and two pieces of thread in equal length. Then what you have to do? Yes, the coconut shells are hung at equal distance from the center of the beam. Okay, then our beam balance is ready. Then what you have to do? Play with your beam balance using stones. How can you use this one? Yes, place a big stone on one side of the balance and continue to add small stones to the other side. Okay, until the weight holders are at the same horizontal level. Count the number of small stones the weight holder and record it, which will be the mass of the big stone. Do you understand? Okay, collect two coconut shells and some thread, and instead of this cardboard, you can use a stick also. Okay, with the help of your parents, everybody should do this activity. Okay, now we are going to learn addition and subtraction of weight. Addition and subtraction of weight. Do you remember the addition and subtraction of length? What we did? Yes. Did you do the homework? Yes. Now listen here. Now we are going to add the weights. First one is add 7 kilogram 250 gram and 2 kilogram 135 gram. Okay. First we have to arrange the numbers in this column. See here. First we have to write kilograms and then the second column there is grams. We have to start addition from the column of grams. How can we start? 0 plus 5. 0 plus 5? 5. 5 plus 3? 8. 2 plus 1? 3. Clear? 385 grams. Now, in kilograms, 7 plus 2? 9. So, what's the answer? 9 kilogram, 385 grams. 9 kilogram, 385 grams. Did you understand? Yes. Any doubt? Okay, okay. Now, one more example. Listen, here also we have to start addition from the grams column. Okay, listen here. 8 plus 5, 13. Carry 1. That carry over we have to add with this 3 and 2. What we will get? 1 plus 3, 4. 4 plus 2, 6. Then 8 plus 3. 8 plus 3, 11. Carry 1. That carryover you have to add to this kilograms column. Clear? Actually, it is 1163 grams. Okay, that we can write 1000 plus 163. 1000 gram is equal to 1 kilogram. That 1 kilogram we move to this kilograms column. clear? This one carry over you have to add with this 5 and 1. 1 plus 5 6, 6 plus 1 7. Next one 8 plus 2, 8 plus 2 is equal to 10. Clear? So what did you get? Yes, 107 kilogram, 163 grams. 107 kilogram, 163 grams. Clear? Yes. Next, we are going to learn subtraction. Subtract 28 kilogram, 73 grams from 73 kilogram, 195 grams. Listen carefully. Yes. Here what we are going to do? Yes. First, you have to arrange the given measurements like this. 73 kilogram, 195 grams. 28 kilogram, 73 grams. Here also we have to start subtraction from this grams column. Okay. 5 minus 3, 2. 9 minus 7, 2. 1 minus 0, 1. Clear? Then next, 3 minus 8. We know it is not possible to subtract 8 from 3. So what we will do? Yes, we will borrow 1 from 7, isn't it? So here we got 1 10 from this 7. Here left 6 tens, and that 1 10 we added with this 3, we got 13. 13 minus 8, 5. Clear? 6 minus 2 is equal to 4. Clear? Now 45 kilograms, 122 grams. Clear? The measurement, what is the sum? 45 kilogram, 122 grams. One more question. Subtract 21 kilogram, 325 gram from 85 kilogram, 838 gram. Arrange the numbers like this. Start subtraction from the grams column. 8 minus 5, 3. 3 minus 2, 1. 8 minus 3, 5. Clear? Now 5 minus 1, 4. 8 minus 2, 6. What is the answer? Yes. The difference is 64 kilogram, 513 gram. 64 kilogram, 513 gram. Clear?
Children, now we are going to do an experiment. Look here. There are two jugs and a glass. Clear? One big jug, a small jug and a glass. Now, we are going to measure the capacity of this small jug. Clear? Listen carefully. I am using this glass to measure the capacity of this small jug. See, from this big jug, pouring some water into this glass. One glass of water that I am going to pour into this small jug. Okay. Again, two glasses of water. Again, listen, three glasses of water. Then again, four glasses of water. So we can say the capacity of the small jug is four glasses of water. Clear? The capacity of the jug is 4 glasses of water. At home, we will use the glass for measuring what? The quantity of milk, water, etc. Isn't it? So, we can use the glass to measure the capacity of a container. See here, we can say here in this big jug there is some more water left. See here, there is water. So, what we can say is the capacity of the small jug is less than the bigger jug. Clear? Capacity of the small jug is less than that of this big jug. Clear? Now, by using this glass, we measured the capacity of the small jug. Okay. But the standard units of measuring capacity is liter and milliliter. Do you know what is capacity? Yes, capacity means volume. Clear? Capacity means volume. That is the amount of liquid a container can hold. The amount of liquid that a container can hold is called the capacity of the container. The standard units of capacity is liter and milliliter. Clear?
Children, next we are going to learn capacity. Do you know what is capacity? Yes, tell me. What do you mean by capacity? Yes, capacity is the amount of any liquid that a container can hold. What is capacity? Capacity is the amount of any liquid that a container can hold. Clear? See here, these are some examples. Then next, there are capacity is measured in milliliters and liters. Milliliter, in short, ml. Milliliter is used for measuring small capacities like that, a cup, a spoon, etc. Listen, milliliter is used for measuring a small capacities like a cup, a spoon, etc. Milliliter is written in ml in short. Did you understand? Yes. The next one is liter. Liter is used for measuring large capacities like bottles, jugs, water tank, etc. Okay. In short, we can write L. Liter is used for measuring large capacities. Any doubt? No. Now, one worksheet is here. Some pictures are given. You have to tell these capacities of this given pictures are measuring in milliliter or liter. First one is a syringe, isn't it? What is the measurement of in the syringe? What is the measurement in the syringe? Liter or milliliter? Yes, we know milliliter, isn't it? Then a bottle of water in liter. Then cough syrups, milliliter. Water tank in liter. Did you understand? Okay, children, 1000 milliliter is equal to 1 liter. 1000 milliliter is equal to 1 liter. 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. Everybody should learn this equation. Okay, 1000 milliliter is equal to 1 liter. 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. Clear? Okay. Now, we are going to read the measuring jars. These are the measuring jars. See here, in the first jar, there is some liquids. Okay, can you tell me the quantity of the liquid in the first container? Yes. See here, up to here, 500 milliliter. So, up to here, 1 liter. The first container hold 1 liter of liquid. Clear? Now, look at the second container. Tell me the quantity of liquid in this second container. Yes, 500 milliliter. Clear? Like this we can read the measuring jars. Clear? Look here. Look at the first container. Tell me the amount of water. Or tell me the quantity of liquid in this first container. Quantity of liquid in this first container. See here. 100 ml. 200 milliliter, 300 milliliter, 400 milliliter, 500 milliliter, 600 milliliter, 700 milliliter. So, the reading 700 milliliter. So, here in the first container, there are 700 milliliter of liquids. Second, look at this cup. 250 ml, 500 ml, 750 ml. So, here in the second picture, there are 750 milliliter of liquid. Did you understand? One more example. Look at this beaker. Can you tell me the quantity of liquid in this beaker? Yes, there is 200 milliliter of liquids. Clear? Like this we can read the measuring jars. Okay. Next we are going to learn addition and subtraction of capacity. Okay, addition and subtraction of capacity. Listen carefully. Add 4 liter 210 milliliter and 3 liter 620 milliliter. Same way, we have to prepare the table. Arrange the given measurements like this. Start from the column of milliliter. 0 plus 0, 0. 1 plus 2, 3. 2 plus 6, 8. Clear? Now look at the column of liter. 4 plus 3, 7. So 7 liter, 830 milliliter. 7 liter, 830 milliliter. Clear? One more example. Add 75 liter, 270 milliliter and 83 liter, 320 milliliter. Yes. Now we have to arrange the given measurements in this table. Start from milliliter. 0 plus 0, 0. 7 plus 2, 9. 2 plus 3, 5. Isn't it? Now look at the liter column. 5 plus 3, 8. 7 plus 8, 15. 158 liter, 590 milliliter. 158 liter, 590 milliliter. Clear? Yes. Children, these are all for today. Now you have to do your textbook exercise. Children, next we are going to do subtraction. Look at the first question. Subtract 65 liter 487 milliliter from 98 liter 630 milliliter. Clear? What we have to do? Yes, first we have to arrange our table. Write the measurements in proper places. Now look at, now we have to start the subtraction from milliliter column. Look at ones place. 0 minus 7. We know it is not possible to subtract 7 from 0. Isn't it? So what we will do? We will borrow 1 from tens place. Okay. From here we will borrow 1. 1 10. That 1 10 we will add with the 0. So we will get 10 there. Isn't it? Here in 1's place we got 10. And in 10's place there is remaining 2. Okay. Now look at this 1's place and subtract. 10 minus 7, 3. Very good. Next, look at 10's place. 2 minus 8. Again, it is not possible to subtract 8 from 2. So from this 100's place we have to borrow 100. We added that 100 with this 10's place. So we got 12 there. In 100's place there is remaining 5. Now look at 10's place. 12 minus 8. What is 12 minus 8? Yes, 4. Isn't it? Now look at 100's place. 5 minus 4. 5 minus 4 is equal to 1. Here we got 143 milliliter. Clear? Now look at liters column. 8 minus 5, 3. 9 minus 6, 3. So what is the answer? 33 liter, 143 milliliter. What is the answer? 33 liter, 143 milliliter. Did you understand? Yes. One more example. Subtract 87 liter, 105 milliliter from 468 liter, 143 milliliter. Okay. Here also we have to arrange the given measurements in this table like this. Start the subtraction from milliliter column. Look at ones place. 3 minus 5. Okay, here also we have to borrow 110 from this tens place. See here, we are going to borrow 110 from tens place. So in tens place there is left 3, isn't it? And in ones place we will get 13. 13 minus 5. 13 minus 5 is equal to 8. Clear? Then 3 minus 0. 3 minus 0 is equal to 3. Okay. 1 minus 1, 0. Now look at this liters column. 8 minus 7, 1. 6 minus 8 is not possible. So from this hundreds place we are going to borrow 100. So we will get 3 in 100's place and 1 in 10's place. 16 minus 8 is equal to 8. Now we have to keep this 3 itself. Okay, bring down this 7. Sorry, bring down this 3 here. 381. So what is the answer? 381 liter, 38 milliliter. 381 liter, 38 milliliter. Did you understand, children? That's all for today. So our chapter over. So you have to do all the exercise. Also you have to do the activities. Okay, learn this chapter well. Thank you.